In this class, I'm going to explain about a Butterworth approximation. In this, already I told you already the Butterworth we analysis the filters LPF, HPF, and the BPF and the all type of filters with the approximation of Butterworth approximation. Here we are going to analysis our filters by using these Butterworth approximation analysis. Here the filter used denominator polynomial of transfer function of its transfer function having is a Butterworth polynomial is called Butterworth filter. Filter in which denominator polynomial of its transfer function is a Butterworth polynomial is called a Butterworth filter. The filter for the designing of filters, it consisting of an Butterworth polynomial is called Butterworth filter. The Butterworth polynomials of various orders are as shown below. By using these Butterworth analysis, we are going to design the filters. So, in the designing of the filters, the denominator consisting of these Butterworth polynomials. Let us know how to analyze the filters by using this Butterworth analysis. In the equation, the denominator consisting of an Butterworth polynomials. So, in this below, we have some Butterworth polynomials of various orders are placed. Here, these are the Butterworth polynomials equations of various order. N means order, Butterworth equation, polynomial equation. Here, we have the polynomial for the first order, the polynomial equation in the denominator for the designing of filter is S plus 1. For the second order, S, that means S power 1, that is the first order equation of the Butterworth filter. And for the second order, in the denominator, S square. For example, we have the gain by for the designing of an LPF filter for second order. For this designing of an LPF filter for second order, by using these Butterworth equations, the equation consisting of an S square, final equation is consisting of an this polynomial equation, that is the indication of a designing of an filters here. Third, that means S square plus S plus 1 plus of S plus 1. This is the second, third order, and continuously we have the orders by using these polynomial equations. We are designing the filters. So here, the first order Butterworth low pass filter, in this low pass filter, the first order low pass filter, we have the final equation in terms of an S plus 1, that means S power 1 plus 1 means the first order low pass filter. So here, we have the circuit, VI is given to the non-inverting terminal and R1 is given to the minus terminal, that means inverting terminal. Node A and node B across inverting and the non-inverting terminals. RF is the feedback resistor. V output is the output resistor capacitor here. So here we are going to analyze low pass filter for the first order Butterworth. Okay. Here the first order low pass filter Butterworth filter is realized by RC circuit. Here we are going to use the RC circuit used along with op-amp used in the non-inverting configuration. Here we are using the non-inverting configuration for the analysis of an low-pass filter by using Butterworth analysis. So it's named as the first order LPF Butterworth filter is realized by using RC filter and also along with RC filter we are going to use the op-amp. For the designing of filters, we are going to use the resistors and capacitors along with some op-amps. So here, in the op-amp is used in the non-inverting configuration. We already know about a non-inverting configuration and inverting configuration. Here, we are going to use a non-inverting configuration for the designing of filters and also some op-amps. By using the RC circuit, we are going to design LPF filter by the analysis of Butterworth analysis. So here, we have a circuit here. For this circuit, we are going to analyze the circuit analysis for the LPF low pass filter. So here, we have the circuit already shown in the last slide. So here from this circuit we are going to write VA of S. That means at node A, the voltage across node A we are going to show drawn here. We already taken from the non-inverting configuration. So op amp is taken from the used in the non-inverting configuration. So from the non-inverting configuration, we are going to write a voltage division rule at node A. At node A, we are going to take the voltage division rule. So for that, VA of S is equals to across voltage. We have the component capacitor C. We have the capacitor component C. So for that, C capacitor, we are going to take the transconductance of capacitor. Transconductance of capacitor is written as 1 by SC. You already know for capacitor, we are taken 1 by SC for the simplification purpose by total number of components in the network or R and C. So R plus 1 by SC. We have to add the total number of components present in the network. So VA of S is equals to 1 by SC plus total number of components or R and C and the input applied to the node and the input applied to the configuration, non-inverting configuration is VA of S. So we can write from the network, from the circuit, VA of S is equals to 1 by SC by R plus 1 by SC into VA of S. So here taken VA of S and VA of S is taken here 1 by SC by R plus 1 by SC. So here we are written like this 1 by R SC plus 1. Why? Because SC SC gets cancelled. Finally we are getting 1 by R SC plus 1. So here we are getting VA of S by VA of S by VA of S. So we want V output. So here for the non-inverting configuration we have to write up this equation from the non-inverting configuration of LPF filter. So from the non-inverting configuration from the first unit we already know V naught by VI. V naught by VI means gain. Gain A naught is equals to 1 plus RF by R1. You already know in the equation for the non-inverting configuration, the standard form for the non-inverting configuration is 1 plus RF by R1. So here we have gain A naught is equals to 1 plus RF by R1. So from that we are going to write from 1 and 2 we are going to write here V naught by VA of S. VA of VA means input here. V that means is equals to A naught. So here from 1 and 2 we are going to write V naught of S by VA of S. V naught of S by VA of S is V naught of S. V naught of S is here. Here we have V naught of S by VA of S. That means V naught of S here and the VA of S here. So V naught of S and the VA of S is taken here. H of S is equals to V naught of S by VA of S. That we have the terms. Multiply these two terms, VA of S by VA of S and V naught of S by VA of S. Then we can get multiply those terms here we can get A naught into 1 plus we have to multiply these two terms we can get an output S. So here A naught into 1 by 1 plus SRC. So finally we are getting A naught. Multiply these two 1 and 2 we can get simply we can write 1 plus RF by R1 as A naught, no problem. So here we can get A naught by 1 plus SRC. By multiplying these two equations we can get an output. So non-configuration mode means here the non-configuration equation and also voltage division rule. By knowing the voltage division rule and non-configuration formula we we can get total output. So here we can get A naught by 1 plus SRC. So we already know that S is equals to J omega. So in the place of S, I am going to substitute J omega. That means A naught by 1 plus, in the place of S, J 2 pi F RC. In the place of S, J 2 pi F RC. Omega means 2 pi F A naught by 1 plus J 2 pi F RC. So here, where FH upper cutoff frequency, you already know about a low pass filter. Low pass filter means it allows the frequencies which are having the low pass. For example, FH, if it allows the, it stops the frequencies, a stop band, it is a pass band, it passes the bands which are having less than, F is less than FH. It is a low pass filter, whereas high pass filter, it allows the values which is F is greater than FH. So, FH is upper cutoff frequency. FH is upper cut, it is the cutoff frequency, upper cutoff frequency. So it is written as 1 by 2 pi RC. We already know the frequency value F is 1 by 2 pi RC. From the second unit, you already know it this. So in the place of an V naught by V in as in the place of an 1 by 2 pi RC as A naught by 1 plus J FH by F by FH. Why? Because here we have 2 pi RC in the place of an 1 by 2 pi RC. We are going to write A naught by 1 plus J of F by FH. So we can get like this, A naught by 1 plus J F by FH. So here we can get output V naught by Vi as V naught of S by Vi of S is equals to A naught by 1 plus J F by FH. So it is a total output coming from the network. So we have to take the magnitude equation and the phase angle from the equation. We are write a little like this for the magnitude. Square root of 1 plus F by FH square. 1 A plus IB means square root of A square plus B square. So here A means heat it is and B means it is. So square root of 1 plus F by FH whole square. It is a magnitude and a phase angle is given as, phase angle is given as minus tan inverse of A by B means V by A. V by B is here, A is here, F by FH. Phase angle, it is a magnitude term. For the phase angle, we have minus tan inverse of B by A. So here it is B, that means minus tan inverse of B means F by FH. No need to write A term here. Phi is equals to minus tan inverse of F by FH. At a very high low frequency, F is less than FH. Then I already draw the equation. When it is F, if it is H, when F is less than FH, when F is less than FH, it is the area. F is less than FH, that means that is equals to A naught. We have A naught by 1 plus J F by FH now. So in this, where F is less than, that means FH is greater here. When FH is greater here, we have only gain. Gain is infinite. Gain is high. When F is here, F is less than FH. That means here frequency is less. When frequency is less, gain will be increases. The gain will be increases when F is less than F. What happens to when F is equals to FH? When F is equals to FH, the gain, that means F is equals to FH, the two terms are equal. We can get A naught by square root of 2. That means square root of 2. 1 by square root of 2 means 0.707. When F is equals to FH, that means the total two are equal, when two are equal, from the magnitude term, we already a naught by square root of 1 plus f by fh square. When these two terms are equal, we can get a naught by square root of 2, that means 0.707 a naught. That means here over 0.707, the gain is up to here only, that means medium gain when f is equals to fh. What happens when f is greater than fh? When f is greater than fh, v naught by vn is less, that means we can get an totally reverse from when f is greater than fh, the gain will be decreased. That means from a naught by square root of 1 plus f by fh, when whole square, when f is fh, it is greater. That means we are a naught is fh is greater, sorry, f is greater, then we can get a gain minimum, gain will be decreases, the gain will be decreases when frequency is more. Here when frequency is more, the gain will be decreases. Here it is clearly shown that when frequency is more, the gain will be decreases. So it is like that. So it is a graph, it is a frequency response curve for the low pass filter. I already explained here, we have a naught when f is less than fh. When f is equals to fh, we have these 0.707 a naught. That means when f is less than fh, the gain will be more. Here, see here, a naught, when f, that means a naught, when f is equals to fh, 0.707 a naught. When f is greater than fh, the gain will be decreases. That means the frequency increases, the gain will be decreases. Frequency decreases, the gain will be increased. That is the point here. Here it is, we have gain will be decreases when f is greater than fh. So it is a graph, it is a pass band, it passes the values when f is less than fh, and the remaining bands are attenuated in the low pass filter. Stop band means attenuated here. With minus 20 dB per decade, it will be attenuate the attenuate the bands. It is a pass band area, pass band. It allows the only the bands which are having f is less than fh, and attenuates the values which are having f is greater than fh. That means in this space the gain will be decreases. So frequency scaling means we are going to the method used to change the original cutoff frequency. Original cutoff frequency, that means here we have cutoff frequency fh, f, and the gain. We have cutoff frequency fh here. Change the cutoff frequency fh to a new cutoff frequency fh1 is called as frequency scale. So here for our convenient, for our requirement, we are going to change the cutoff frequency so that cutoff frequency is called as an new cutoff frequency is called as an frequency scale. So that's named as an FH to FH1. For our designing purpose, we are going to change the cutoff frequency to the another level. That process is called as an frequency scale. So here we have the new value for R dash is given as R of FC by FC dash. Here, see here, FC means original cutoff frequency and FC dash means new cutoff frequency. That means we are going to change the frequency, cutoff frequency from FC to FC dash. Here, we are going to write the R dash as a new value of R dash is a resistor which is used here. for the designing of filters, resistor of FC by FC dash means original cutoff frequency to the new cutoff frequency. That is the simple concept of frequency scaling. So here we have the first order Butterworth high pass filter. I already explained about a low pass filter. Here it is same exact process of low pass filter here to the low pass filter. For the designing of an IPS filter, we simply replace the components which are using in the low pass filter for the designing of an high pass filter. So here we have the circuit for the designing of an high pass filter as R1 here, RF is a feedback resistor, VI is the voltage applied at the non-inverting terminal, and the R is the resistor across non-inverting terminal, and the capacitor is placed at the non-inverting terminal, and the VI is the applied voltage at the non-inverting terminal, and the V0 is the voltage across the terminal. So here apply potential divider rule at the A, we get at the A here node A is present here, voltage divider rule, we are having VI is taken as the voltage across a component is R, and the total number of components present in the circuit are R minus C. Here C is represented as minus JXC. Why? Because for the transconductance of capacitor, it is represented with minus JXC. Capacitor is represented with minus JXC at anywhere. So, and into applied voltage VI, voltage divider rule at node A, we are having VI is equals to R means R by R total number of components in the present or R plus C into the applied voltage across the circuit VI. So VI is equals to R VI by R plus my C is taken as minus JXC. So I write here R into VI by R minus JXC, where minus JXC is written as minus J means my 1 by J. XC means you already know XC as 1 by 2 pi FC, 2 pi FC. So in the place of XC, we are going to substitute 1 by 2 pi FC J. So 1 by 2 pi XC J. So VA as V1 into R by R plus 1 by 2 pi FC. So J here VA as written as J taken to this numerator J VA 2 pi FC by 1 plus J 2 pi FC. So here R get cancelled when we are taking the common R here. VA by V1 is taken to here for the simplification purpose. J 2 pi FC by 1 plus 2 pi FC. We are getting the first equation like this. For the non-inverting terminal, we are filter out the Butterworth filter by using the non-inverting configuration of op-amp. For that, we already know for the non-inverting terminal, the op-amp output as V1 plus RF by R1 into VA. So, we have A0 here, it is the gain here, 1 plus RF by R1, phase band gain of filter. Also, V0 is equals to A0 into VA. For the simplification purpose, it is considered as A0 into VA. So, put A0 value, V0 is equals to A0 into VA. So, substitute the value of VA in equation 2, we are getting V0 is equals to VA0, VA as VA, we are getting VA as J V1, we are get already J V1 2 pi FC by 1 plus J 2 pi FC. Here we have V0 is equals to A0 into this term. So then V0 by V1 is taken common, A0 into J 2 pi FC by 1 plus J 2 pi FC RC. So we are going to write FL is equals to 1 by 2 pi RC. You already know FH and the FL as low cutoff frequency and the higher cutoff frequency 1 by 2 pi RC. So from there FL is written as 1 by 2 pi RC. So V0 by VA is equals to 1 by, in the place of an 1 by 2 pi RC, we are going to put as FH, FL. So J into, in the we have A naught J 2 pi FC by 1 plus J 2 pi FRC. From there FL is equals to 1 by 2 pi RC na. So A naught into J 1 by 2 pi RC means F by FL, 1 by FL. One plus J F by FL. That is the term we are getting here. In the place we already shown, this is simply like a low pass filter. So we have magnitude for this A naught is constant. So we can put like this, F by FL by 1 plus A plus B. A plus IB means we are going to write a square root of A square plus B square. Square root of A square plus B square means A is here. 1 plus B means F by FL. So F by FL square. Square root. So here we can simply write A naught by square root of 1 plus F by FL whole square. Simply we can get the magnitude from this. We are having the graph like this. Simply it is very simple terms. These are very simple terms. No need to confuse at anywhere. It is simply the equations from the low pass filter and the high pass filter. Only the components which were used that are replaced here in the high pass filters. So here we have the graph, we have the frequency response graph like this. Very very simple concept. It is very easy when we practice this. Okay, here the frequency response curve, here we already know the high pass filter which passes the filters which are having F is greater than FH. That means if it passes the bands which are having frequencies greater than FH. That is the concept here. The frequency response curve for the gain and the frequency is when F is greater than FH, then it passes the bands. Is a pass band. The stop band, that means when F is less than FH, it does not pass the bands. It is a reverse operation for the low pass filter and the high pass filter. When F is greater than FH, the gain will be increases and the gain will be medium, and F is equals to FH. When F is less than FH, it will zero. The gain will be decreases. It is a reverse operation for the low pass filter circuit. So this is the class for the Butterworth analysis of a low pass filter and high pass filter. By tomorrow's class, I'm going to explain the Butterworth filter for the band pass filters and band reject filters. That's all. Thank you.